This is Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
This episode is about the one-dimensional elastic collision. In this episode, we are going to determine the velocities of the two colliding objects after the collision, discuss some particular cases.
One-dimensional elastic collision, or head-on elastic collisions. What do we mean by one-dimensional collision? Watch this short animation. Two balls collide with each other. As you see, the velocities of the centers of mass of the two balls are on the same straight line. This collision is said to be one-dimensional collision. So, a head-on or one-dimensional collision where the velocities of the centers of mass of the two colliding objects are on the same straight line. Now, consider two objects, A and B, of respective masses M1 and M2. Make a head-on elastic collision. Let V1 be the velocity of object A just before the collision, and V2 is the velocity of object B just before the collision. After the collision, let V1 prime be the velocity of object A right after the collision, and V2 prime be the velocity of object B right after the collision. The question now, determine the expressions of V1 prime and V2 prime in terms of M1, which is the mass of object A, M2, the mass of object B, V1, the velocity of object A before the collision, and V2, the velocity of object B before the collision. Now, let's start. During the collision, the linear momentum of the system AB is conserved, so we can write P system just before the collision is equal to that right after the collision. P system initial can be replaced by M1 V1, which is the linear momentum of object A just before the collision, plus M2 V2, which is the linear momentum of object B just before the collision. These two terms is equal to M1 V1 prime, which is the linear momentum of object A right after the collision, plus M2 V2 prime, which is the linear momentum of object B just after the collision. Since the velocities are in the same straight line, so the vector relation can be written in the algebraic form. So M1 V1 plus M2 V2 equal M1 V1 prime plus M2 V2 prime. Take into account that V1, V2, V1 prime, and V2 prime could be negative, positive, or zero, since they represent an algebraic value. Now, take M1 as a common factor on the left side and M2 as a common factor on the right side. Then M1 into V1 minus V1 prime equal M2 into V2 prime minus V2, which is equation 1.
Now, the collision is elastic, so we have kinetic energy of the system before the collision is equal to the kinetic energy of the system after the collision. This is going to be 1/2 m1 v1 squared plus 1/2 m2 v2 squared is equal to 1/2 m1 v1 prime squared plus 1/2 m2 v2 prime squared. The halves cancel out. This is going to be m1 v1 squared plus m2 v2 squared is equal to m1 v1 prime squared plus m2 v2 prime squared. Now, take m1 v1 prime squared to the left side and take m2 v2 squared to the right side. This is going to be m1 into v1 squared minus v1 prime squared is equal to m2 into v2 prime squared minus v2 squared. Now remember the difference of two squares. So v1 squared minus v1 prime squared gives you v1 minus v1 prime into v1 plus v1 prime, while v2 prime minus squared minus v2 squared gives you v2 prime minus v2 into v2 prime plus v2. Now we have two equations. Equation 1 from the first slide and equation 2 from this slide. So let's divide equation 2 by equation 1. Now M1 cancels out, V1 minus V1 prime cancels out, M2 cancels out, and finally V2 prime minus V2 cancels out. This is going to be V1 plus V1 prime is equal to V2 prime plus V2. Rearrange, we have V2 prime is equal to V1 plus V1 prime minus V2. This is equation 3.
Now, we have two equations with two unknowns. Using the expression of V2 prime, or substitute the expression of V2 prime in equation 1. So, we get M1 into V1 minus V1 prime equal M2 into V1 plus V1 prime minus V2, which is V2 prime. So expand M1 V1 minus M1 V1 prime equal M2 V1 plus M2 V1 prime minus 2 M2 V2. Here we have minus V2 two times. Okay, now take the terms that include V1 prime to the right side and the other terms to the left side. So we get M1 V1 minus M2 V1 plus 2 M2 V2 equal M2 V1 prime plus M1 V1 prime. Now take V1 prime as a common factor on the left side and take V1 as a common factor on the right side. So we get V1 prime into M2 plus M1 equal to V1 into M1 minus M2 plus 2 M2 V2. Finally, divide by M1 plus M2 both sides. We get the final expression of V1 prime, which is M1 minus M2 over M1 plus M2 times V1 plus 2 M2 over M1 plus M2 times V2. Using equation 3, we can write V1 prime equal V2 prime minus V1 plus V2. Similarly, substitute V1 prime in equation 1. So we get M1 into V1 minus V2 plus V1, because minus times minus equal plus, and minus V2 equal M2 into V2 prime minus V2. So we have V1 and V1. So this expression can be write as M1 into 2V1 minus V2 prime minus V2 equal M2 into V2 prime minus V2. Expand, we get 2M1 V1 minus M1 V2 prime minus M1 V2 equal M2 V2 prime minus M2 V2. Take the terms that include V2 prime to the right side and the other terms to the left side. We get this expression. Take now V2 prime as a common factor on the right side and take V2 as a common factor on the left side. We get 2M1 V1 into M2 minus M1 V2 equal to V2 prime into M2 plus M1. Finally, divide by M2 plus M1 both sides, we get the final expression of V2 prime, which is M2 minus M1 over M1 plus M2 times V2 plus 2M1 over M1 plus M2 times V1.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now we have the expressions of V1 prime and V2 prime. Let's study some particular cases. We will start with M1 is equal to M2. Now we will replace M1 in the expression of V1 prime by M2. This is going to be M2 minus M2 over M2 plus M2 into V1 plus 2M2 over M2 plus M2 into V2. The first term becomes 0. This is going to be 2M2 over 2M2 into V2. 2M2 cancels out, so the answer is V2. Finally, we have V1 prime is equal to V2. This means that the final velocity of the first object is equal to the initial velocity of the second object. Now let's move to V2 prime. Similarly, we replace M1 by M2 in this expression. So this is going to be m2 minus m2 over m2 plus m2 into v2 plus 2m2 over m2 plus m2 into v1. The first term becomes 0. This is going to be 2m2 over 2m2 into v1. And the answer is v1. So finally, we have v2 prime is equal to v1. This means that the final velocity of the second object is equal to the initial velocity of the first object. So we conclude that the objects exchange their velocities. Now Rabia will show you the experiment of this case.
Consider the two marbles having the same mass. The two marbles make a head-on elastic collision. In this experiment, we are going to verify that after collision, the two marbles exchange their velocities. Let's start the experiment. Before collision, I will push the two marbles towards each other, and marble 2 is slower than marble 1. Observe and then conclude. We notice that after the collision, the two marbles move away from each other and marble 2 now becomes faster than marble 1. This result verifies that the two marbles exchange their velocities after collision. Let's do another experiment with the same marbles, but now one of the two marbles at rest. Let's say marble 2 is at rest while marble 1 moves with a velocity v1 towards marble 1. Observe and then conclude. We observe that after the collision, marble 1 becomes at rest, whereas marble 2 moves with a velocity as that of the first marble. We can conclude from this experiment, when two objects having the same mass make a head-on elastic collision, they exchange their velocities after the collision.
Now, let's move to another particular case. V2 is equal to 0. Now, replace V2 by 0 in both expressions. This is going to be v1 prime is equal to m1 minus m2 over m1 plus m2 into v1, and v2 prime is equal to 2m1 over m1 plus m2 into v1. Now, what if m1 is greater than m2? Observe this term. This term is positive. So, v1 prime and v1 have the same sign, which means that the first object continues in the same original direction after the collision. Now, observe this term, which is always positive. So, v2 prime and v1 have the same sign. So, the second object, which was stationary before the collision, continues in the direction of v1. So, we conclude that the two objects move after the collision in the direction of V1. Now, Rabia will show you the experiment of this case.
Now, the first marble of mass M1 moves from left to the right, while the second marble of mass M2, such that M2 less than M1, is initially at rest. Let's do the experiment and observe what happens. As you see, the two marbles move in a direction as that of V1.
Recall that we were studying two colliding objects, one of them initially stationary. Now, let's move to another particular case. What if M1 is less than M2? So, this term becomes negative, which means that V1 prime and V1 have opposite signs. So we conclude that the first object bounces back after the collision. Now let's move to V2 prime. This term is always positive, which means that V2 prime and V1 have the same sign. We conclude that the second object continues in the direction of V1. Now, Rabia will show you the experiment of this case.
In this experiment, the first marble of mass M1 moves from left to right with a velocity V1, while the second marble of mass M2 greater than M1, is initially at rest. Let's do the experiment and observe what would happen. We notice that after the collision, The first marble bounces back, whereas the second marble moves with a velocity as that of V1.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.